Hello, this is Chris of Magoosh. I have some cool mental math I can't wait to share with you. Let's dive in. What we're gonna be doing today is multiplying by halving and doubling. What do I mean by that? Well, I have a question for you. What is 25 times 12? Ding, 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 ding. Hey, do we have the copyright for that? No, okay, never mind. Didn't hear us hear that song, but I would probably play the whole thing out and you'd be like, no, don't make me do this, I don't know. Fine, how about 50 times 6, do you know 50 times 6? And boom, by now you probably should have said, yeah, 300. 5 times 6 is 30, add the 0. That wasn't hard. Well, 25 times 12 is the exact same thing. What do I mean? Well, if you double 25, you get 50. And if you halve 12, you get 6. So when you double one number and halve the other one, you still end up with the exact same number. But when you're multiplying something that ends in a 0, it's a much easier thing to do. So 25 times 12, I'm gonna double 25 to get the 0 on the end there, half 12, get the 6, 50 times 6 is 300, boom, we got it. Okay, do you wanna have another one like that? I'm gonna throw it at you, and you can actually pause and try this at home. I think that's always fun. Here it is, 16 times 5.5. Pause it, what are we gonna do? Okay, I assume you've done that, or maybe you figured it out really quickly. 5.5, well, we want it to not have a decimal, so what could we do with that 0.5? We could double it. So double 5.5 is 11. But if we doubled 5.5, what do we have to do to that 16? We have to halve it. So 8 times 11 is 88, or 16 times 5.5, which looked really hard a second ago, is simply 88. Pretty cool, right? Well, let's do one more. 2.25, uh-oh, oh no, 0.25 times 36. What should we do here with that 0.25? Well, if we doubled it, we'd still have 0.5, but if we quadrupled it, or multiplied it times 4, we'd get the 0 at the end. So 2.25 times 4 is basically, let's double it once, 4.5, let's double it again, that's 9. So now we have to reverse quadruple 36, or essentially just divide 36 by 4, which is 9. So 2.25 quadrupled is 9, 36 reverse quadrupled is also 9, so 2.25 times 36 is 81, or the same as 9 times 9. Super cool, makes things much easier. You don't always have to go scrambling for the calculator, and that can definitely save you time test day. So hopefully you enjoyed solving those seemingly intractable looking math problems, doing doubling and halving and quadrupling. Now, if you want more, we have math free resources for you in the description below, so click on that to access that blog post. Or if you want more videos like this one, click on the ones to the left. And I will see you next time.